Hi Tony, thanks for giving us this opportunity of this interview. I really would like to know some curiosity from your career and from your work. First of all, what was your first approach to manga?
I think it was first the anime that I saw on TV. Okay. And then after that, I discovered the manga the anime came from. In particular, that was Dragon Ball and Ranma. Okay. On TV.
Ranma has been also my first manga.
It's a great one. Even now, my daughter is reading it. She's enjoying it like crazy. So it's even really relevant even now. It's okay, cool.
Yeah, it's really funny, and there's also that kind of battle component that's really amusing, and it's a very interesting kind of manga.
And,
yeah.
And also something that we discover with the discourse changing right now, the discovering of an identity. Ranma is both male and female. Yeah. Everybody's okay with that. Yeah. And that's telling something. That's pretty cool to see that nowadays with this look. This is pretty great.
Fantastic. So, you've been the first European mangaka to be published in Japan. How was it? Has it been a hard journey?
I wasn't involved in the decision of it. Okay. Otherwise, I would have done it before.
Before, yeah.
So, I work hard like crazy, but we are all working hard doing this job. Okay. And I got lucky. That's the difference. So, I got lucky at a certain time, and that was the moment where it takes off. I really think that pretty much all of it is due to the luck and the moment.
And emotionally, how it was?
It was frightening because I knew that if I didn't do it well, because everybody was watching, that would be hard. And so I was more afraid than happy, I would say. And until then, I never really enjoyed how it feel, because I'm afraid if I do that, it will go away, you know? So sometimes it's crushing, sometimes it's okay, but it's never great, the best feeling.
Like a strange situation, because, you know.
Every year, I think maybe once or twice, I wake up and I'm not able to restrain myself, and then I feel it, I say, wow, this is, no, stop.
You know, great.
For like a few seconds, I feel that every few months, maybe once a year, something like that.
Are there any other mangakas that you like and you've been inspired by?
A lot, yeah. So I talk about Dragon Ball. So Akira Toriyama is really one of the best one. Rumiko Takahashi also for Ranma, because the way she draws the characters and also the way she writes emotionally the characters, I'm really into that. And then One Piece and Naruto has been a huge influence when I was beginning to draw my own manga. That was really, and Bleach also.
And what about the new mangakas of these times? Is there anyone that impressed you in particular?
I've always been impressed by Yusuke Murata, whatever he does. Murata, that's my favorite drawer ever. And even nowadays, that's pretty much the best for me. Koei Horikoshi, even if now it's not brand new, but I'm very, very impressed by the amount of work he's doing and by the quality of everything in My Hero Academia. Everything, the writing, the drawing, the style, the plots, the character design, the character, how they are written. Everything is impressive. And then I'm reading Jujutsu Kaisen like everyone. I'm enjoying it. This is really fun, really, really cool. Demon Slayer, of course. It's very, very nice. But in the very new one,
Dandadan is great.
Dandadan, really, I think a big masterpiece in becoming,
Nice. So, let's talk about Radiant now, okay? Do you have an entire view of all the story, or you are developing it while working?
I'm both. Okay. I have the backbone of the story, I would say. So I know where I'm heading to, and I know many of the steps that I have to go through, to go to the end. But I give myself the freedom of enjoying the moment. So I say, okay, I'm at the beginning. I know where I have to go, but how do I go? This is the freedom that I allow myself. So new characters come in, new subplot is developing more than what I prepared. Things like that, I take the freedom in it.
Have you ever been inspired by real people to create characters of your manga?
Yes. A lot.
a lot.
Yeah. So first, without knowing it, I was writing myself in pretty much every important character. One that me when I was a teenager, another one would be some fear that I have, another one a type of personality I develop if I'm in this type of mood. So every character, important character, has a trait of mine that is overdeveloped.
Okay.
So I'm into pretty much all of them, even the villains, okay, the one that I don't like. They represent a fear that I have or some path that I don't want to go to. But then I also take inspiration from people that I know around me, even not knowing it sometimes. And I realized that afterward.
And what about the influence of things happening in these times? I mean, in Radiant, a certain category of people is kind of discriminated by others. And is that the occasion to talk about something like racism and give a positive message to the readers?
It's been the case since the beginning of Radiant. I'm not particularly influenced by what is happening right now because it's always been like that pretty much. What I try to do is to bring characters to have different point of view on the subject, and I try to bring them with good ways of thinking about the problem. So not always, not everyone speaks the same way on one problem, but I try to make that appealing, consistent and true to what I believe in.
Okay.
Even if I'm not completely agreeing sometimes. And so I try to have more of a perspective and questions that answer. I'm not a moralistic person. I don't want to bring a moral into people's mind.
Okay.
And say, you should think that this is bad. No, I try to take a perspective of, let's try to deconstruct it.
Okay.
And see how it works and why I think, in my opinion, that it may could work in another way. And that's what I'm trying to do.
You're showing something to the readers and you let the readers choose and interpret your transposition of the things that you feel, maybe.
I do that, but I also give my answers.
Okay.
Through the characters.
Okay.
I don't say you have to follow that. I just give something that is dear to me to answer to a question that is in my mind.
Radiant, now it's a worldwide success. It's published in many countries and got the anime, so it's very interesting, and it does not happen for every manga, so it's something great. We will ever see any merchandise like figures or stuff like that? Because some fans asked this to me when I was coming to you for the interview.
Yes, there will be a few statues that will come out in the next
okay.
At the end of the year or next year, an art book. There are already many things existing. T-shirts, mugs, and stuff like that. But there will be more, yeah, of course.
Okay. We are very happy about this, and thank you again for this interview. And please send a greeting to all the Italian fans that are following us and that are supporting Radiant.
Ciao. Thanks, everyone, for the support. Every time that I come in Italy, I feel really welcomed by the readers, and I have many readers from the beginning, from 2017, that I've seen today, for example, and I always feel blessed by that. Really, I feel really lucky to have you on my side, so thank you, really.
Thank you again, and thanks, Tony. We're very happy for this interview. Bye.